Just to provide some explanation regarding letters of recommendations, in your resume, sometimes you provide the reference on the last part of your resume. You provide reference name or reference. You normally for reference, you need to put either the previous managers or previous boss or previous organizations. That means the boss that you're working with. Or if you don't have working experience, you need to provide the lecturer names or the teacher's name. So that's a reference. So normally the organization will ask this reference, the names and the phone number and the address that provide regarding your backgrounds, the candidate background. So, and sometimes you already provide the recommendation letter of the reference together with the resume, or if you apply through online, for example, need to fill in the application form, sometimes they already ask you to provide the recommendation letter together with the application form. So the use of that recommendations letter actually to check the background of these respondents or of these candidates or the applicants. Okay, next slide is regarding the slides of the selection process in the organization. So it starts with the initial selections where the organization send out the advertisements on the either on websites, online, magazine, newspapers, and so on. And the applicant send the application form. So the informations from the applications, the organization use as a rough cut to select the candidates. Maybe to select the candidate that met the basic requirement of the job. So that's our selections, initial selections mentioned here. Goal is to use as for preliminary rough cuts to decide whether the applicant meet the basic requirements or not. And second is substantial recruitment. Here, substantial recruitment, sometimes the organizations or the recruiters or the manager or the HR will select from the initial selections, maybe through a written test, performance test, or interview. Normally, when we apply for the jobs or when organizations send advertisements, the applicants or the candidate who got called for interview normally have more chance compared to without the one who didn't been called for interview. So interview is a common practice for substantive selections, but it's not only interview, it can be through a written test, performance test also. It depends on the positions that the candidate apply. So at these substantive selections, applicants who meet the basic qualifications here but less qualified than others are rejected. Normally, those who are successful at this point will move to this point, but it's not necessarily we'll get hired, but sometimes also we get rejected. So is applicant among the best qualified, and then lastly is contingent selections. Make final check before offer or making offer to the applicants before the organization can offer the jobs to the applicants. Normally they already decide, but they just wait until the applicant be able to pass the drug test or medical certificate exam or not. So I mean X-ray normally. So here applicant who are among the best qualified but who fail contingent selection are rejected. Let's say the applicants fulfill all the requirement, but when asked to go for drug tests and also X-ray and other tests, normally medical tests consists of many tests, can be urine tests, can be X-ray and so on. So even though if they fulfill the first two requirements, initial selection and substantive selection, but if they fail a drug test or medical exam, so they still will be rejected. So the applicant who fulfill all these tests will receive the job offer. So that's the selection process, start with the initial selections, the first information received from the applicants. And then through interview, written test, or performance test, or any other test, if the candidates pass this test, we go through these contingent selections where the applicants need to undergo some drug tests, medical exam, and so on. So if they fail, they still will get rejected. If they succeed, they will receive offer or job offer. So substantive selections, that's mean on the second level, substantive selections, this selection is at the heart of the selection process and it is used after the applicant pass initial screening. So after they pass initial screening, now they have to face the recruiter. So at the beginning here, they just send the application form or the resume, and then the recruiters or the HR or the managers will view their application form, and then they will make a rough cut. That means they just screen which application form fulfill the basic requirements. So they do not meet the candidate face to face, or they didn't call just yet. So here they call the candidates who fulfill this part. They sometimes call for interview or to do some tests. So here, the applicant need to do some tests, for example, written tests, performance simulation, a simulation test, or interviews and many other tests. So written tests normally is a paper and pencil test. So this is quite common, paper and pencil. Long time ago, we tend to call paper and pencil test. Now we call it written test. Paper and pencil is like you need to have paper and you need to have pencil, and then you need to fill in your information, or you need to fill in your answer based on the questions given, or sometimes based on the essay that you need to write regarding the questions that the organizations ask. So written test is typically test of intelligence or cognitive ability or personality and integrity. So this is very common, this test, before they call. Sometimes they have this test with the interview together. First they need to answer the test, and then later they call for interview, or sometimes they use this, just this one. So written test or paper and pencil test is basically a test including personality test, integrity test, intelligence test. This is very important for certain company. If you pass this test, you have more chance to go to call for interview. When I applied a long time ago, when I studied in Australia, I work in one of the company in Australia. So I actually, before I call for interview, before I apply, I already answer or already pass this kind of test, intelligence, cognitive test, personality test, and integrity. So that test actually is kind of considered as a qualification that the company will look together with the other qualifications, skill, and so on. But sometimes the company themselves ask the candidate to sit for the test. But if the candidate already sat for the test, maybe already fulfilled the test and have the result show with the and show during the interviews or attached with the application form, then easy for the company to just maybe call for interview. So when I apply for the job in Australia, I already fulfill in this test and I already passed this test. So when I apply the job, I attach this test, the result of the test, together with the application form, and then they prefer that way because easy for them to call for interview, because it is will be their screening already, their selections already. So what is mentioned here, written test, is when you fulfill the initial screening, you have to sit for this test, written test, during the substantive selections, you have to sit for this test. So one of the tests is intelligent test, as especially is very important to determine whether you can be particularly a good predictor for job, whether you can be best employees or good employees or not in performing your job. So intelligent test is very important to determine whether you can be a good employees or mean best in your work or not. So intelligent tests are particularly good predictors of a job that require cognitive complexity, that require cognition, that require thinking, problem solving, and so on. So tests in intellectual ability, special mechanical ability, perceptual accuracy, and motor abilities have shown to be moderately valid predictor for many semi-skilled and skilled operation jobs. So this indicate that other tests may be as not as good as a intelligent test. Because it's mentioned here, other tests, for example, all these intellectual abilities, mechanical, whatever these tests, it just moderately valid predictors for semi-skills and also unskilled operative job. But core intelligent test is considered as a good predictor. So this test is important. So normally organization will use this test compared to the other tests. Also, this test also using intelligent test can also be a good reason, a valid reason to defend the company themselves when the candidates got rejected because of failing of this test. So because it is moderately valid, so if the company use this test as a kind of requirements to select the employees, and maybe the candidate who got rejected, they have a more valid reason to sue the company for inappropriate recruitings or selection and so on. So that's why many of the organizations do not really apply this test, because they do not really ask their respond or their candidate to sit for this test, but normally the organization will ask the candidates to sit for intelligent tests. So unethical problem have increased nowadays. When we talk about organizations, there are many ethical problems increased in the organizations. So especially for retail companies, for banking companies, for organization that relates to money or relates to relationship, dealing with the products, especially with the money, integrity test is considered very important and have gained popularity. So for if you want to work for example for retail company, for example in Malaysia, Tesco, Giants or any company, sometimes they ask you to sit for integrity test, because integrity test will predict whether you be honest in performing your work or not, or you tend to steal from the company or not. So integrity test will determine whether you are an honest employees, you'll be good employees, you will not steal from the company and so on. So this also considered as a paper and pencil test. Normally when we talk about paper and pencil test, it's basically like a multiple choice. You just answer the options already there, you just choose among the options. So this paper and pencil test measure dependability, carefulness, responsibility, and honesty. So this considered as an integrity test, very important for a company that's dealing with money, such as retail and so on. Evidence show that these tests are good predictors, but care should be taken to use the right test. So in any other test also, it is important to take some precautions to find the test that consider right for the positions. So such as for the retail company, for the retail jobs, normally they will use integrity tests most of the time to select the candidates or to select the employees who apply for the jobs. Okay, these are among the tests that the organization use substantive selections, the method that they use. For example, performance simulation test. These are one of the performance simulation tests, include work sample test, assessment center, situational judgment test, realistic job review, and interview.